Okay, cool. All right. Now see why, which you can see in the top there. You can read the code. All right. See right now. Switch over. Show you more detail. What I'm currently working on. Got these health bars here, which we round. I can resize round, size more precise, and what I'm going to do is there's another version for party frames, target frames I got to get made that are based on this design. They're a little bit more compact here. Those. I'll have the two versions good to go. Alright, so pop back code. So we can see this page right here. That's my debug. As well as my console down here, which auto build code thing. If I make a change. That's the big environment here. How's it going? I'll leave a preview up. See as it goes since it auto rebuilds. First things first, I need to make that text white. Close to the white for the numbers. Here. The reason why it's black right now is because it's border on it, which I'm going to get. The X bar, right? This. Delete that, rebuild, and it should auto update. Let's start on the version real quick here. Here, a bunch of functions, all the different portions of it. And here, these build different versions of the little elements. We're going to do a mini player. Have an SVG background for this, so we don't need one. It's just a square. Might want one. I don't think I have one made right now. Yep. VG Mini here is actually the small one. Now, up on there. Oh, well. On the right side there, so you can see it. All right. Actually, I don't even. Yeah, no, I don't think I need an SVG background. It's just a rectangle, and this circle picture I can fill in the background there. We'll just do that. The first thing we're going to do is add in a portrait, which I've been just using the bacon stuff. And my portrait class I already have right now mostly work. Then get something up here so we can see it.
Oh yeah, coming in on that. Like, okay, what are you in charge of?
Create a widget for player health. On player health. A lot of this is going to be data driven from the client server stuff later. Settings, but for right now, just to make something easy, I'm doing it as mini, make that optional, and then if it's mini, I'm gonna play render the mini version right here. So it is their status bar mini. And if not, we're going to do this one that's not mini. Not like doing that in multiple lines. This. Inline doesn't always work. Now we have a switch for if our mini one or the full self is mini. Place this here with R. That, and it's gonna auto reload. You're not gonna see any preview. Well, these minis actually gonna be false because it's undefined and not set to anything. But just to make sure things are always what we expect. Mini equals product stuff. Just set it, default it, and then use this mini here. Okay, if it wasn't passed in and it's undefined or null or something, it's false by default. We use the full one. Now that we have that, back to the component. I haven't added any other sections here, so we'll add a new case. Install that mini self. Turn this mini. What we call this mini self. Okay. Now, if you want to see what this looks like right now. Going to be this bar right here. I'm gonna move these out of the way. Zoom in. The one I'm working on right now. Lock that in place. And set this to be by default. Health. Worry about that part later. We'll do it just mini is default, so we're gonna change this to true. Make mini the default. Build. Sorry, I'm not paying attention to chat too much. Working. There we go. All we have is a circle. We had it. Since things are built of components, it's put everything here. We have a container class. Player health bar that's getting passed in that component. So I'm going to make this player health. Actually, I need to change the naming because we had this conversation Friday with the mod squatters. Naming of it could be player health, bar, and this is maybe, pretty sure that's how it works. Correct me if I'm wrong, or me, any of you. Pretty sure that's what I want to do. Test for that. Here. What the big one was. Most of it's going to be the same. So yeah, I'm going to use the same. This player health bar. What I'm going to do is actually add the class mini. Cutting off a little? Is my voice cutting off? Probably because I'm talking quietly. That's probably better now. All right. So with the mini version, this based with this. Let's clear status bar. Doing the wrong thing here. Yeah, you know what? It's just gonna be because of this. We're gonna do this. Do that. And default width and height to something much smaller. Let's just say for now, let's do like 200. 225 pixels for now. There we go. What are we getting over? Player health bar out the mini. Oh, right, because I did that class on the wrong one. Mini is there. Back. There we go. Now I have a giant box. What we're going for is this. Yeah, the bacon people were from one of Michelle's streams. I took a screenshot. There we go. Now, portrait needs to be adjusted. So my portrait function right now, I take in a left and a URL for the portrait. I'm gonna add in also a the parameter in here called mini. We'll add class on there. Well, mini. If it is mini, we'll add mini. If not, we'll not add any other class onto that. And so the other functions calling it will be fine because I added it to the end. Default. So this one we're gonna do left and mini. Actually, you know what? I should just do this. Instead of position, we're just going to call it style. I don't need a special thing for any. These left and right are for the big ones. We don't need a mini left and right. Instead of that, we'll just do mini here. And CSS. The portrait. See, we got the left version, the right version. Add a version for mini. And we're gonna make the left to zero, so it's not offset. Here we go, not offset. But we want the circle to be not in that box, so we'll actually make it go back 50 pixels because that's how wide that image is. Yeah, I'll get it. Here we go. Here's the portrait. We don't need mini on there anymore. Here we go. Thank you. Alright, now we want next. We'll look over here. We want our pills for our blood, stamina, temperature, and panic. Blood, stamina, panic, temperature. Put those next. And they'll go here. So let's. I have a blood and stam function right now for party and for full. The party version that I made earlier, you can see down here, is on this one, which is exactly what I need. I'm just gonna reuse that. See how that looks. Might need to add a little bit of style changes to it. Likely. So this design was done in collaboration with one of our mod squadders, Tiersis, and James Q, and myself. But yeah, this is an early design, and we're going to be iterating, of course, as things go. Okay. This is close to what we want. So I'm just going to switch over to the browser screen and see what settings I want to do. Like, I don't want this padding on it, but we want some padding. So I'm just do it all here because I can immediately see it. So we want, like, 50 pixels is what that is, so let's say, like, 52. I'll put that there. And top, we want not, probably like 2 pixels. There we go. And next on the bottom, we want the numbers and letters. So I think that's close enough. We might need to move the height a little bit. So maybe like 70 pixels height. Well, we can mess around with that later. So we need a mini version of player status bar, blood, and stam. We want this mini version. Okay. that. I make a mini version. That overrides our left to be 52. Our top to be 2 pixels, and we'll just do height right now as placeholder, like 70 pixels. And that's gonna be cool. Oh, whoops. Oops. I'm using Visual Studio Code, which is a free open source editor from Visual Studio, Microsoft. Okay, so there's that, and it's already built and rebuilt, and you can see it up there, how that looks. And then now we want the little tentacle things, the health bars. Alright, so body parts. Add body parts. Default body parts are going to look like the other ones. They're going to be all offset, so you're going to have to make a special class for it, but it's just add it in there and then work from there. Yeah, I used Sublime for years, but I'm completely on VS Code now. It's amazing, especially if you're doing TypeScript development. It's awesome. If I was doing plain JS, you know, it'd still be debatable. I might still be on Sublime, but doing TypeScript VS Code is amazing. All right, so that's what we have right now. Status bar, body parts left. We're gonna want this to be a mini version, and we'll probably want it to be on the right. So let's just see what sounds we want. Right, 0. Don't want a left. With our other styles. Oh yeah, let me switch back over the other one. All these guys. Are not getting the I didn't pass in the mini. Need to pass in that mini stuff to the blood and stem. Was not done. Not done with you. Alright. So we'll change this position to style. Then pass in mini. And I know we have to do the same thing. Plus one. So we'll do that in body parts as well. Pass in mini. There's a whole lot. So it takes the position, which I'm going to change it to beat style. And that'll give me player status, body parts. Artfire, don't really have an answer for you on that. I just always have. I don't really have a preference. Just whatever looks good. So now, here we are, and we want to, got Mini here, on this guy. I type padding right instead of left. Oh, right. I messed that up. Back to the code. Alright. What we're gonna do is... this body parts. Mini version. Mini version is going to have right zero. Beast. Oh, so I did these all here. So they're all gonna have be even, so they don't need any special styles. But that's only if I'm doing mini stuff. So, guess I could do that. That'll just, if it's mini mode, we don't want to do the custom styles for the offsets of these guys. That's how I did the going around different angles of these. So, now mini mode doesn't have that. Here we go, now they're all straight. We also don't want them to be skewed. So these ones right here that have the right and left where I do the skewing on that class. So we're going to change this to basically the same thing. Mini. Just not gonna have the right. Do the same thing for the left ones. So pills don't need to be skewed. Oh, Boom. Not skewed. You have more offset there on the H and T. What am I doing here? Margin bottom zero, margin bottom zero. Oh. Everything else has a margin top of 6%. Right. Okay. No. No. Let's learn. Each has low margin on top of it. Have a little margin on them. Oh, that L has been below it. Parts label. Right, I'd zero it out here. Okay. So, and do another little change here. Still want font weight bold. Question the gray, what's up? There we go. Now they're all in a nice line. Now we just need them to be in the right spot. We need this. Over here. What do we got? Body parts, so we wanted to do right zero. Probably want bottom. So let's do like 75. Work. And make it bigger. That's parts. Mini. So we wanted right zero. Top 75%. Width 215. And 18 is fine. It's fine. And we also want the section to be a little bit bigger. This section set is to the height of 75%, so we'll do that. 5% higher. Technically, there's no HTML, it's all React, and the reason is I'm doing that instead of making unique classes for some of those things, because what changes? The inline stuff here, I mean, there's not much inline, it's really this stuff right here. It's because I don't want to make a new class for each of the different body parts. They all share the same, and then I just do a little bit inline in React. Performance-wise, there is zero difference. Completely negligible. It's pretty large, but I think I zoomed it in a lot. I think that's about the size it would be. Probably some things I want to do, like, it looks alright, maybe. James Ku, our designer, will go through and do a more arch pass and CSS and stuff. I just get things into a as good of a state based off the design as we got, and then goes through and adds things. And yeah, the little bacon picture doesn't fill the whole thing right now because it's very small. So there wouldn't be that empty space in the bottom normally. Final release is going to be very, very different from beta. I'll make the non-self version of this. Party version. Yeah, our game is not gonna be like that. Like, I mean, the game's modern, obviously, but yeah, no, our beta is not like a final game with just some bugs. It's going to be very much a beta. Zadrid,
yes.
There are many plans for doing that picture there. It'd be a profile picture of your character. Depending how things go. Maybe it might be a 3D rendering of your character. Who knows? Right now, it's just a picture that I put in there. Hello, mini stuff. Mini stuff for party. And this is calling this the party health. Mini party. Little party. Set the default for now. Place this with bar. And edit our class here to be properly supposed to be now. Mini version, be smaller. So I still do the mini version here. Pretty two step. With being the same, doesn't make quite sense. So let's make this smaller by default. 200, I guess, for now. Oh, wait, that's the party one. They open the same file. Ignore that. Right, so we did 250. And that's 276. That's fine for now. We'll do the same. 200. Right. Yeah. It could be an optional thing. Lots of things we can do. Make things optional. That's also why we have two different versions of this UI right now. Options. People like things, you know. Made like a very micro minimized version of our health bar UI. A lot of people like, and some people want the bigger one. We're gonna make a mini party. Mini party. Which mini party doesn't have a portrait. Bam, no portrait. So we're actually going to change this to mini party for Blood and Stamp because we don't need it to be left aligned. This one's fine, whatever. We're going to go to Blood and Stamp, which is right here. And we'll make a new one. New class called Mini Party. And no padding left. We're just two pixels. Should be fine. Yeah, I've not used the HSLA stuff. CSS is not really, I mean, I use it, but I don't like, I'm not like use all the latest, newest stuff in CSS. Alright. Our party, which is having some issues. So we'll fix that. I did set it, that's player health. Some of our streaming's gonna be different. I just decided to stream today because I'm working on UI stuff. That is visual. Alright, so. Party one. Party health bar mini. Is that what I called that thing? Party health bar mini. Just to make sure. The game, but also not horrible. There we go.
I'll go look in the. I'm sure it's
so big.
Back there or something.
We do not have.
I don't want. Other than that, I'll just say I don't want pretty much the exact same part of. That was fixed. Not a bad one. I was looking for one that Max could comfortably run the game. I've got a.
I don't know when the summer streaming will be. It's a thing Mark has to say when that is.
I don't care. I mean,
there is a bit of a delay. Here. I can flip over. So as you can see on the left side of my screen here, I have my command line open. This is all actually up on GitHub, by the way, if you want to take a look at it, if you're trying to see how my thing updates by itself. I have, I use npm scripts, so I just ran npm run dev here, which then launches a live reload server, which is, it starts a new little tab with live reload. It opens up a watching, I use a npm watch. Which then, whenever it detects any files change, like any TypeScript files or TSX files, it runs my full build process. If a SCSS file changes, it runs the SAS build. So the SAS build stuff is near instant. The TypeScript stuff has to get built by the TypeScript compiler, and then built by Babel, and then compiled with Browserify, and then it works. So that takes a good like 30 seconds to actually see updates for that. And then this was just a web server, HTTP server that's hosting all the files. But they all start up automatically. Run npm run dev. Opens up a browser. But what I need to do is make these. This section needs to also have left. It needs to have no width. Width needs to be 100%. So left 0. Just do width 100% again. Damn. It's only gonna be on mini party. So I need a body parts mini party. Yeah, all the stuff's up on GitHub. Our mod squad works on this stuff. So if you want to see it, this one's actually on my personal, but right now I haven't pushed this stuff to the mod squad repo. But we'll be up there. Up on the live one when it's ready. But you have here is the our public repo. What I'm working off of, you can actually download it and play with it right now if you even wanted to. is here, is on my repo. My personal GitHub with on the HUD branch. I can add that right now so you can have the latest. And if you look at my repo, my commit line, my commit names are terrible. I rebase everything and make it nice and pretty before I submit it up to CC Games or CU Mod Squad. My personal repo, I do lots of commit things, messages that are like stuff and things, like this one. I have a ducky keyboard with brown switches. They're browns. Back to the code. Yeah, I don't want them to be super loud in the office. They're just close to the mic, so you hear them right now. I don't want to, my keyboard clicks, like if I had reds, everyone in the office would hear me type all the time. Alright, what was I doing? I need to make a mini party on player status. This. So this one, we're going to make a mini party version. Which I don't need any right if I just do it with them 100%. Should be fine. Now I just need to put that here. Whoops. This.
Well, you don't need a program to do that. You can just
place
that
shit.
That's just my default in there.
Yeah. So here's the body part.
Go around one day and check it. I'm going to share this.
So I need to just pass it the style and mini party. Mini party.
I just
want
to put it together.
I mean, like, webcam is here, keyboard is like a foot and a half away. Talking about keyboard clickies. Alright. Building. Whoa. That didn't work because I have a check on the top that says is mini. This, or. Style. We can make this more efficient later. Mod Squad likes to go through and find all the things that I did quickly and be like, Chibi, you can make this better. Which is great. So thanks. You need a position to get it in the right spot. So, left 0. So we do have mockups, which I have over here. These mockups were done. One of our Mod Squad guys, Tiersis, did it, along with James Q, our designer in the office, as well as myself. We, like, talked about it, did a lot of back and forth. He uses Envision. So, and see, we have a mock-up. Yes, the UI is going to be completely moddable. and it's all HTML, CSS, so you can make your own stuff and also change our stuff however you want. All right. Well, we had a human body part, not read very well. This actually reads a lot better. The mini version, not so much for most people, I don't think. But the mini versions are meant to just take up less space. But the larger versions are more like this one. The larger version, which the text is supposed to be white right now, but to your body part health, as well as your blood stam, panic and temperature. I don't think there's any difference here. We'll just make. Group the body parts. I'm not sure what you mean. Properly. Oh, like in a different order? I don't know if I want to add. I mean, it's possible we could add customization to that grouping. And if people don't like the having left stuff on the left and right stuff on the right, we could potentially change that. We'll see how things go. Alright, so that's that. They have names now. This is about the size. Let me get the actual sizes real quick. I'm gonna clear my local storage. This is stuff actually, it all gets saved. We use local storage to save UI positions and whatnot between, between sessions. And I think I'll add an API method so you can save them for like account globally. All right, refresh. So that's default size. Oh, we wouldn't want those smaller. Especially compared to the default size of the other one. These are supposed to be mini. So, let's try 150. Very smushed. Very, very smushed. Make the height smaller. See if we can fit. Uh-oh. Broke something. Okay. It is smaller. Now these don't quite fit. Smaller. Don't worry about smaller later. Pills here. Those are all fine. Body parts. Pills. Undo mini party pills as well. Mini and mini party pills. Both be the same. Set their height. It is 100% and it's based off the total height of the region. Got it. There's that is body parts. This one. Blood parts mini here. Don't change the height. Here be, let's say, 75 for now to see what it looks like. Half. This is very small. This one should not be taking up whole space. Width should be the mini. I actually set a width as a fixed number. It should just be 100%. A good one. I want the actual width of this whole thing to be bigger, because we have that extra 50 pixels from that photo picking it up, so make this 200. And we have a target, which is going to be the same as the party. But I'm going to actually make one that's mini target because it might be different in the future. But we'll just use the same code inside of the player status bar. Here we go. We have a target. Party people here. The other thing party people have, though, and everybody has, buffs. And yes. Active effects. Do two mini party first. Pull the other ones out of the way. Off screen here. Zoom in. Build faster. Yeah. All right. We're obviously not in the right place. But we'll do the same thing. We'll add a little mini tag to it. Send in a mini class. I'm gonna change this and do. didn't actually use it. I'm gonna use it now. Alright. Do a little bit of string interpolation. Style. While I'm at it for the class one, I'm gonna have to do that class icon next to. Change that. And name, I'm gonna change that to style as well. So for consistency's sake. Now we have clear status bar active X. Add a mini version. And this version actually is going to be on the right. I think what I want to do here is I want to do row for a flex, so they actually go vertically instead of horizontally. Actually, because we want it to be on the outside, so we left 100%. Damn. Row wrap should. We want these to be vertical, and we also probably want this to have a smaller version, smaller and mini and mini-sized. Change this to be mini size. Smaller, but we still want them to go vertically, horizontally. Pop over here. Flex direction doing nothing. What's my flex direction? Invalid property value. Maybe because of the wrap. Does that do anything? There we go. Maybe if I, you know, wrote CSS properly. Alright. So this one we actually wanted to be row. I don't know where that wrap came from. Alright, position wise, up. Want it to be at the top. Top is going to be 0. We're going to do a margin left. Like 2 pixels. So it's got a little bit of spacing. I think that'll work. Now let's see if we just add a bunch more. See how it looks when there's a bunch of them. I think what it's going to do is it's going to keep going down, and then you set a max height. We want a max height of 100%. That doesn't work. That's what we want. Mini, we want flex, wrap, wrap, max height. We're going to want to do the same thing for the non-mini version. We're going to want a flex wrap, wrap, and a max width of 100% for that one. And then we can double check that one. Turn the party one back into full version. See how that looks. I broke it. What do you mean, law? What did I? You'll be able to see one of these little party things up for each person. Everyone in your party will have a health bar on your screen. That's what these party bars are making right now. Broken with something.
Well, random with these wide angle cameras, they can probably see.
Portrait is huge.
No updates. It's a break. Is this? This should be 100%. She's in love with the concept, as if we're all just how she imagined. Cause we're in love, I just don't know yet. But tell me how I'm supposed to see the magic. Cause I don't believe it no more. But I won't tell her, cause I always imagine it's easier if she thinks she won. So I'ma let her. And she said, I don't think I'm gonna be broken. You never seem to call me lately. Girl, I don't think you know me at all. Never thought I'd have to say this. No, I don't love you. And I never did look at us burning down in flames for kicks. But just know I'm just sitting on the floor. So that makes it easier to see. We seem to be having skill issues. Just the bars on the side. Here. These things need to have a minimum width. Here, as a flex one, flex direction. Well, I wanted to be right. That's so small, React doesn't need to do Ajax calls. Like, that's a separate thing. React is rendering. Now you tell it to what to render, you can do however you want. You can do Ajax and stuff. Actually, I use Redux for that. For managing the state. What did I do? It's gonna be a size thing somewhere. Is it because this needs to be this? Bam! Oh, you didn't see what I did. Yeah, so this class here, remember I had renamed it earlier? I had it like that, which was the old name. It needed to be 2 underscores. There we go. So big now. Back. Portrait. And then I need to make it smaller and I can't click the button. We'll just reset storage. When it refreshes, it'll go back to default settings. Damn. Let's make sure all of them still look good. Party one. There. And target. All need to be working. And we're actually going to have a secondary target, ancillary targets. Yeah, it's going to be a lot of stuff going on. Here we go, that's what we wanted to see. So we wanted to see this guy working. All of the buffs and stuff. I don't think we need as much spacing around all of them. Right now I got margin of 2%. Don't need that one, a 2 pixel margin. That's an actual effect. Yeah, those are your buffs or debuffs. There, we can heal the leg real quick. Just using hard-coded stuff for right now. So, buff leg. We'll give you like 9, 21. Mostly healed. Well, Zadra, the component did mount, right? That's just something that's called when your component is mounted. So it's like when you're actually using the component in the page. Whoa. I got. Oh, that's fine. Alright, so that when it gets mounted in the page. So it's just like a function that's like, hey, we're actually using this thing, so that's a good time to potentially put up some AJAX requests or whatever. But if you're going to use React, there's much better ways to do that than just calling AJAX requests during lifecycle methods on a React component. Because you can use something like Redux or Flux or whatever that do a lot of state management stuff. the gem. Show you here how we do that. So this is how I do the Redux stuff for the layout. Right now we have this is where we have these methods that we can dispatch. Which these can be synchronous or asynchronous. Right now they're just synchronous. So if they were async, they can do something and then return back. So comes down through the reducer, and basically it'll the action through return of the AJAX request, if this head async stuff would come in through this action, which was get sent from one of the other functions above. We update the state, return out the state that gets passed into it gets merged with other reducers over here. Don't need to go into the huge details of it, but eventually what it does is it comes back around and I listen to it. Whoops. Pass it in, create a store using that reducer. Pass it into my component, container component, which then essentially la-di-da, Redux magic stuff later. It I select it and it comes in basically in my props. Want not too much explanation, but basically comes in that state, whatever I had in that quibble state. I can select it here and put it into my props. It also gives me a dispatch function, which is how I call those functions. So like if I want to do an AJAX request, I can dispatch an asynchronous function that I wrote in that other class, which then handles it all and then re-updates the state and sends it back and then re-renders the components. And just so you connect it down here. Right, so, well, you got mail from Twitch probably, but this was just kind of impromptu. I was working on this stuff. So, with that state though, I what I do here is I keep the, in that layout state, I keep the positions of all the widgets that I have. You can see my layout state is here, which I have a widgets, which because it's TypeScript, I don't really have a way to define this, but it's basically using it as a dictionary with the string name and then the position. So I can move things around. Save it. In sessions. So, refresh the browser. There, same spot. And I can open it up in another tab. And you can see it's still in the same spots. Eventually, I'll make a button in the interface stuff to, it's not just this little toggle lock here, but also you can reset, which will, reset will basically just do a fear of the storage, go back to default, break things, or make it such a way that you don't like it anymore. Okay. Target is having issues though. Let's fix this. What did I do with that one? I don't know. Forced chaos? Don't know yet. But I'm still getting visions. going on here?
So most things with the pod. The mod that's a ball control at one base mode. This is just like on the cube map, right? I can't remember why they're all fucked up. This is this one, this one, this one, this one. All of these, gone through all of them. Like, looked at the material, then gone in and looked at the material.
What did
and
I do? See if
anything was set to a setting or like a all type.
Right. Oh, I also renamed that one.
Something wrong? I don't know.
I set that one to use the party health stuff. Here we go.
I did it by hand. I was going through and
causing problems sometimes.
No. I mean, I like all the things that I looked through that were being used. What I did is I went in and was like,
so what I did in the target index file, I copied and pasted, remember? So we need target health here.
Deprecated several materials, marked them as deprecated, subbed in other similar
target health. And then our SCSS actually needs to make this the target health. New style, bar. And then I need the mini version, which is basically the same as the party player, not player, same as the party.
Well, what I want to know is the zone, the small controller.
It's exactly the same as the party, but just because it's a different widget, I'm going to duplicate the SCSS here.
Yeah. I mean, if you can give me the, if they're going to come in,
structurally, we keep our widgets.
Instead of just all over the place,
completely self-contained here, so we can take this target health component and use it elsewhere. Because it has access to these global components somewhere else.
The zone doesn't know what's in it, knows what's
up. Alright.
Yeah.
So then all that rebuilt. It looks good.
Reverse.
Yeah. Up the way around. No, that makes sense. Okay, I'm in the zone. What's in the zone? No. Here's the thing,
yeah.
What zone
it is.
I don't know if it's
what arguing is going on. Let's keep things civil.
You're gonna have something interesting with it.
But to answer your question on the current dying thing. Head and torso goes to zero, you die. But also if your blood goes to zero, you die. So you have three pieces of information on this bar that can kill you. The TH bars and then the red bar up here. If that goes to zero, you die.
And actually, what I'm doing is literally on the
I know you couldn't hear me. I muted it because you guys were complaining about it. Yeah, so the important things to not die are the torso, head, and blood. Which the head and torso I've made bold here, and they have the background to kind of signify they're more important. But yeah, there's definitely... This is version 1. See how everything goes. And then on the mini versions, the last part that we are missing is the class icons that you see right here on the left. Well, Bull is talking. So the last thing for the minis is the class icons. Yes, you can wiggle around and try to bite somebody's ankle off. Be like the Black Knight from Monty Python. Alright. Okay, class icon. Minis, all the minis need a class icon. And we'll pass in a mini to all of the class icons. Mini. We have the class icon on the right. I don't know if I want it on the left. Anyone have thoughts or opinions? Class icon thing here. Above the bus. Put it on the left side. I was thinking like on the left on the bottom. Based on these ones, it's kind of on the left. Turn it back to mini version. Now, where did this quest icon go? It's like hidden somewhere. Quest icon. Oh, didn't save the file. Save. You're right back. Have it hidden here somewhere. Do it on the bottom. We do that. Eight buffs. all of them need. Yes, TSX is the TypeScript equivalent of JSX. What advantages for what? TypeScript? The class icon is hidden. Oh, right. Yeah, I didn't change the CSS over there. Would you give? Oh, I don't know why I did percentages. A second mark. Yeah. This off the screen. That's awesome. Yeah, these are just kind of placeholder things. James Q just made three little placeholder icons for the three classes right now. But they'll be colored in stuff later. And they'll be unique per realm, not just, like right now, just heavy fighters are this circle, archers are this arrow, not the arrow, the bow and arrow. The healers are plus cross thing. Mini version. So -20 and left 100%. That should be fine. Alright, I think next step is probably doing wounds, displaying wounds. First, to do something. Pills thing. This is our component to render the pills. Basically have two functions for vertical and horizontal. Look at that. Buffs are not in a good place on target and party. Get to that in a few minutes. After I do wounds. So we'll just say display wounds. It will be a default to hot. Thank you.
wound.
And am I typing? How do we determine which pill has the wounds? Well, it's going to be every one-third markers. And feeling our hearts collide, we're on fire tonight. Hear this out. Which gives us the best result. But it's not going to be perfect because the pills are not exact. They're exact for your health, but they're like blocks of health. So the exact, you know, one third. We're going to fill in a pill that contains, you know, the wound percentage. Let's see, something. Do it ugly first. Is wound. So we have to see that the pill is nothing. Zero. And my current number is equal to.
You can see how easy it is. Come here, Chris. It's like going right to that rock. That was a rock. My understanding was I was trying to help.
We'll do this really ugly for you. If it is a wound, we're going to. If it is a wound, and add a new one. And this one's just going to be completely filled in. Kitty color, wound color. Optional. Wound color. So I think this should work. It's not very Not very good math. Alright. And when we use it, we want to pass in a wound color. A wounds. Which is here. Wound color equals two red. Splay wounds. True. Copy. Yeah, you see, they're actually are working right now, but they didn't have a color, so they're invisible. Now they will be colored since it's done compiling. However, that makes the bottom section the last. Sorry about that. We might want to round it down. You have a little bit buffer before you get your first wound. The picture in the background, make it static. Yeah. Get a picture for that. Is a picture from the storm. There's a hole where my heart is, like a sky full of darkness. Now the waters have parted, I still reach for your heart. And I know you're not crazy, just broken like me. I found safety in your instability. I think that's it. Get all shorthand. Why do we not update? Probably because it didn't come to us. No! CSS fail. Right. Sunset Shroom. Hinge.
Apparently, he fell.
Oh, besides, pick one.
Three. Very large for China.
Wounds work. And gotta fix these. Buffs for your target. Primary target. Target numbers. No, that's party. Party needs to party. Target needs to have right. Which will make a great one for. And right. The right ones are going to be at a left of 0%. Max height of ink. Also need to mix with. Alright, that looks better. And then this one next. Goes down there. don't want that. That's correct. What? Out of buffs. Max. I don't think we'll have this many buffs and debuffs. I'm throwing a lot on there to see how it looks. There's not going to be like a million buffs and debuffs on people. See some dynamic wounds going on. Yep. Poor guy's gonna be pretty wounded here in a second. Dead. Try to find you, letting go emotions. I lost myself, trying to break through. I'm following the light inside your eyes. I'm running through the dark into the night. Don't let me go. Gonna move the party stuff out and the markers are wounds, active wounds. So they're coloring in a pill. Which means that you cannot get healed past that mark until that wound is healed up. Alright. Do. Get a.
There's a.
Working on parties now. That's a party one. So, gonna make it so you can actually have a party that's not just one thing. So, right now, the party class. Own it. Widget. Rather. Just. Apparently renders one bar. I'm going to make a party member component that basically does this stuff, and then we're going to manage multiple in the outer widget. Cool. basically all this stuff's just gonna go up here. Oops. Copy. And rename this party stuff to party member. Just need to rename the CSS classes. Also did copy the bar. Need to go deeper. This is not what we want. Okay. And here, we're going to render multiple party members. Just for very basics of things, see that we can do member and say we can have 4 party members. And I'm going to clear local storage to resize our stuff back to smaller sizes. Bam. Lots of them. And you'll notice that they all look all weird and effed up because we did not include the CSS. So we need to include the SCSS because only our root widget SCSS is included in our external widget, and the parent widget includes it. So this one actually gonna have nothing right now other than an import of CSS from components, party member, index. Save that. And bam. There. A bunch of them. As you can see, they're all now grouped up together using the resizing logic from the kernel widget. So we're going to want to potentially even allow for individual movement of each of these. Yeah, pretty much. Turns out it is 7 o'clock.
Cool.
So I'm going to call it a day on this stream and continue this work off stream, maybe back streaming sometime soon. We'll see how things go. But I think it's already been announced. We've already talked about this before. Our initial group for beta size is going to be... but it, obviously that's up to change based on how gameplay works. So, this will be built with 8 in mind to start on. So, have a good one, everybody. Thanks for hanging out.
There are seven.